Hi there, I'm Miles, and today we're going to get you started with your GOM Scan 1. In this getting started, we'll be teaching you how to measure a part using manual measuring plate. Feel free to pause at any point to follow along. There are also chapter segments if you wish to skip ahead. So let's get started. In this manual scanning approach, we use the measuring plate. It has a soft finish on the bottom, so it won't scratch your table while you're moving it around. On the upper side of the plate, I've put some reference points to link the different viewing angles together. For the mount of the game controller, I selected the middle size sensor with the 200mm field of view. As seen in the previous videos, on the right side of the screen, we have the distance radar that helps you put the sensor at the correct standoff distance. If the indicator goes upwards, it indicates that we're too close, and if it goes down, we're too far away. Now I press the button and a first scan's made. Now we rotate the part and add scans to cover all areas on the part. Due to the reference points on the measuring plate, the individual scans are easily and quickly transformed to each other, resulting in one perfect 3D mesh. In addition, with the reference points, we're able to check the sensor status. But sometimes, reference points are not wanted or cannot be placed on a part. In these cases, the measurements can be oriented without using reference points at all. Our software can easily calculate the alignment of the scans by best fit. We just need to have enough surface geometry. To finish the measurement, I press the flag icon. This starts the polygonization, and so then our software will deliver us a detailed and accurate mesh of the part. If you experience anything different from what you've seen here, or if you have any issues with your GOM Scan 1, please reach out to us via support@handsonmetrology.com. For more getting started information, please check out our other videos. Thanks for watching, and we'll see you next time.